お前はもう死んでいる。
何？
Star Wars The Force Unleashed. Man, I remember this game's release like it was yesterday. 13-year-old me was standing in the store looking at an enormous screen seeing the trailer of this game. It was Star Wars like I had never seen before. And around that time, I played a lot of Star Wars games like Republic Commando, Empire at War and Knights of the Old Republic. I saw this guy turn the Force up to 11 by filling up a complete room with Force lightning, throwing crates, rocks and complete starfighters to his enemies like it was nothing. For me, that was not how the Force worked. And this guy was holding his lightsaber backwards. I had never seen that before and had no idea how it worked, but it looked awesome. Though there was a little bit of an issue. I owned a DS and a PSP, but the game did not look as good on those consoles compared to the Xbox 360 or the PS3. So in the end, I went with the PSP version, as the graphics came the closest to what I saw in the store. I was not disappointed with my choice, as the PSP version looked great for the time. The game was also a lot of fun, and therefore I didn't mind going on a long trip or vacation, because that would mean I had an excuse to play it non-stop. But as years passed, I talked a lot with people about the game, and it became clear that there are some differences between the portable version and the console version. Not in the term of dialogue or story, but in gameplay and level design. So for May the 4th, I thought it would be fun to review this game, but on a platform I never played it before. So with that all being said, let's get started. Star Wars The Force Unleashed is a story about revenge, betrayal and redemption. Story elements that Star Wars is familiar with and known for. It takes place between episode 3 and 4 of the main Star Wars movies. You play as Darth Vader's secret apprentice named Galen Merrick, also known as Starkiller. To complete his training, Darth Vader sent Starkiller to kill Jedis that survived Order 66. But he's not going alone on his missions. He's accompanied by Proxy, his murderous training droid, and Juno Eclipse, his pilot. Together with them, you fly across the galaxy, killing everything in your path, slowly becoming stronger and closer to complete your training, so that you and Darth Vader can overthrow the Emperor and rule the galaxy. The story is straightforward and simple. Although it uses elements that are familiar in Star Wars and borrows a lot from the movies, it does not depend on it. The known characters from the movies play a part in the game, but the new characters still carry the story. The same thing goes for locations you visit in the game. Some are mentioned or seen in the movies, while others are completely new. Because it borrows a lot from the movies, the game feels a lot like a Star Wars movie from time to time. But overall, it still stands apart because of the presentation and focus on the new added things. I was really glad that the characters from the movies were not changed and act like they should. I also liked going to Felucia, a planet that was shown briefly in Revenge of the Sith. Or Rexxis Prime, a junkyard planet that is known from the Legends novels. Especially involving the novels is a nice touch for the fans. The story is divided by missions and the order you play these missions are the exact same way on any console. However, there is a difference in the map design. Large open areas are replaced and some levels are completely removed from the PSP version. For example, on Felucia, a whole level is designed surrounding a Sarlacc pit. You even go inside the creature, giving the level a nice twist as the environment starts to play a role as well. It was a surprise to be sure, but a welcomed one when I got to this point in my playthrough. Another surprise is that the game isn't long. In total, it took me less than 6 hours to complete the game, which includes cutscenes and in-game dialogue. Though the length is perfectly fine, as the pace of the whole game is fast, matching its combat. Star Wars The Force Unleashed is a hack and slash game, though I find myself not using the lightsaber that much to hack and slash. The force powers you get are way more interesting. They are not only effective, but most importantly, a lot of fun to use. It also gives you a great sense of power every time you use them. You get more force powers, talents, and combos through a perk system. You gain perk points every time you level up, find certain collectibles, or complete bonus missions. It's a fun little system where the story benefits from greatly, as you get the feeling that you become more powerful over time. I really like the force power combination you can unlock. Force lightning, for example, has multiple combinations. You can surround yourself with a force lightning shield or a dash attack, sending a wave of lightning towards your enemies. My favorite combo is a force push at the end of a lightsaber combo. Batting the stormtrooper off the map like a baseball player made me laugh every time. However, there are some hiccups in the game that ruin the fun. You floor armies with ease and really makes you feel like a strong force user. But from time to time a large enemy enters the battle. Usually it's a walker or a rancor, and while the first few times facing them is really cool, they become dull very quickly. The ways you can kill these mini bosses are very limited compared to the basic enemies. You could still try different ways of fighting them, but their design stops you from doing that. They all have the same throw or shoot attack for long range and a stomp attack for close range. Both attacks will knock you back and stunlock you. Basic enemies also have these attacks, but you have multiple ways to counter them with your force abilities. But for the mini bosses, there's more or less just one way to counter them. Use force lightning to stun them and then get quickly some hits in and stun them again. You basically use the same tactic as they do. However, that makes the fight super easy and it becomes very repetitive. The only time these enemies become difficult is when there are a lot of other enemies around them. But it's not in a good way difficult. You get stunlocked by almost everything at this point, and the only way to overcome this is to be most effective instead of being creative with your force powers. Especially the snipers are a pain, as they can stunlock you very easily, even when you are already stunlocked by something else. The most annoying part is that they are positioned far away from you or even out of range. You could try to get close to them or grab the nearest object with the force and throw it at them. Now, this is a point where I got confused by my memories. I remember in the PSP version that the targeting and aiming for the system was good. Because of that, I really enjoyed the system, but on the Xbox 360, the targeting and aiming was very annoying from time to time. Aiming with the joysticks felt completely pointless, as the object I was trying to throw flew off screen to a completely different target than I was aiming at. You also have barely any control over what you are targeting when you're trying to pick up something with the force. Bit of a shame, because when the system does work, it adds a nice layer to the combat. The boss battles are a bit of a mix. Some battles are awesome, while others are just fine. The before mentioned mini bosses sometimes appear as normal bosses. The use of locations and different models makes these fights stand out, even though you beat them the same way as their mini boss version. Luckily, there are only a few of them, and the other boss battles are awesome. You fight multiple Jedi Masters, and none of them felt the same. They have their own story, design and fighting style, and require a different tactic to beat. Just like with the upgraded mini-bosses, the locations where these fights were taking place played a big role and made the fights more memorable. You do even get some customization options for Starkiller, though these options will become more effective once you replay the game. Every level unlocks a new outfit, and some collectibles unlock new crystals for your lightsaber. Some even have damage effect, but some effects are more noticeable than others. I was impressed by the music. The game borrows classic songs from the movies, but also adds new ones that blend in seamlessly. Especially the Starkiller theme is so fitting to the game and Star Wars itself. Sound design doesn't need much explanation. From blaster bolts to Darth Vader breathing, it's all on point. The voice acting is done amazingly, and there are some fun facts to it as well. Bail Organa is done by the original actor, Jim Smiths, and Starkiller is modeled to look like his voice actor, Sam Witwer, who also does the Emperor's voice acting in this game. There are also many movie references in Star Wars The Force Unleashed. This is to be expected when the game borrows so many things from the movies. On Raxus Prime, a crazy Jedi made a complete copy of the Jedi Temple from scrap, including a Jedi Council. Then there is the Emperor that clearly knows he's a meme by saying, "Do it." And of course, let's not forget, the God of the High Ground himself also makes an appearance.
Hello there.
This game is good. Yes, there are some small flaws, but nothing that ruins the experience. And while it's being a good game, it's also a love letter for the fans of Star Wars. The graphics were amazing on release, and while for today's standards it's nothing special, it still looks alright and has a certain charm to it. The biggest selling point of this game is that you can play as an overpowered force user in a simple, short, but well-executed story. And that concludes my review of Star Wars The Force Unleashed. It's an old game, so chances are you already played it, so let me know down below what you think of the game. If you haven't played it, give it a try. It will at least make a nice addition to your collection. thank you very much for watching. If you liked this video, leave a like and consider subscribing. With that all being said, I wish you a good day and may the force be with you.